In this video, I'm going to share with you what you can do to create a culture that allows you to attract and retain top talent, deliver killer business results, and to create an organization where everybody actually wants to show up to work. What is corporate culture? Some people say it's what happens when the manager leaves the room. I like to think of corporate culture as the side effects of working for your company. Have you ever watched those commercials on TV, and at the end of the commercial for a prescription drug, they start to list all the side effects? Nausea, weight gain, skin discoloration, bleeding from the eyes, and in some cases, death. Well, I remember watching those commercials and thinking, wait a minute, working for an organization actually has the exact same side effects. Where from prolonged exposure, you gain weight, you lose your hair, you argue with your spouse, bleeding from the eyes. We've all been to those meetings, and in some cases, death. So we're not willing to take the prescription drug, yet we're willing to subject ourselves to working for that kind of an organization day after day, week after week, month after month, and year after year. So that's why I think corporate culture is the side effects of working for your organization. The side effects of working for your company don't have to be bad. They can actually be very positive, a sense of purpose and meaning, being able to learn and grow and develop. The side effects can also be dramatically powerful and impactful in a positive way, not just a negative way. I frequently talk and write about employee experience, which is a combination of three things: culture, technology, and physical space. But what is actually required to create a great corporate culture that allows you to attract and retain top talent, deliver killer business results, and to create a place where people genuinely want to show up? It turns out that there are 10 attributes to creating this kind of what I call a celebrated culture. The first part of creating a celebrated culture is making sure that the company is viewed positively. Just like when you bring home a significant other for the first time, you want to make sure that your family, your friends get to meet your potential future spouse or significant other, and you're curious about what other people think. Do they like this person? Do they get along with this person? Do they see you together in the long run? Similarly, you want to make sure that your organization is viewed positively. Does it have a good reputation? Is it known for hurting the environment or hurting animals or treating people poorly? Or is it known as a standout organization that's doing good and not harm? So making sure your company has that overall positive perception is step one to creating that great corporate culture. The second piece is that everybody feels valued. Now, this covers a lot of different categories, but everybody wants to feel valued at work. Like their voice matters, like their ideas matter, like they are being compensated fairly for the work that they're doing, like their presence is being noticed. So if you want to create a celebrated culture, you have to make sure that your employees feel valued. Next, we have a legitimate sense of purpose. Now more than ever, employees want a sense of purpose and meaning, something that allows them to feel and understand how the work they're doing is having a greater impact on the organization, on communities, on society, on the world at large. A lot of people want to work and do something not because they have to, but because they want to. And that is where that sense of purpose, that sense of meaning ultimately comes from. Next is making sure that employees feel like they are part of a team. Work is a team sport. It's no longer just about you versus everybody else. Employees want to feel like they are part of a team, that they are working together, communicating and collaborating and working with their peers who are able to help each other and support each other get things done effectively and efficiently. Next, we have the organization believes in diversity and inclusion. Diversity and inclusion are not the same thing. Diversity is just about having a mix of people. Inclusion is about making sure that everybody feels like they belong. So does your organization bring together people from different backgrounds, cultures, and values? And does it allow everybody to feel like they belong there, like they have a voice there? That is what diversity and inclusion is all about. Next, we have the referrals come from employees. Have you ever been to a really great restaurant or seen a wonderful movie? What usually happens afterwards? You tell your friends about it. You post a review on a website like Yelp, and then other people see that. And now your friends are going to that restaurant. Your friends are watching that movie, or even strangers who read your review are now going to that place that you recommended. So referrals come from employees. This is a fantastic sign, a fantastic thing to pay attention to. When your organization is attracting and retaining new talent, where are those people coming from? Are they all from the outside, or do you find that a large percentage of your new recruits are coming from employees who are referring them to the organization? This is a great sign to look for to tell if your organization is creating a celebrated culture. Next, we have the ability to learn new things and to make sure that people are actually given the resources to do so. One of the worst feelings that an employee can get is feeling like they are stuck in their job, like there is no way to grow and to learn and to develop. So if you want to create a celebrated culture, you need to make sure that your employees have that sense of learning and growth and development so that they can see a future for themselves inside of your organization. Next, we have that your organization treats employees fairly. It's true that sticky situations might sometimes arise, but employees want to know that they and everybody else is being treated fairly. You're not biased towards one idea or another. You're not biased towards one person or another. You are treating everybody fairly and equitably inside your organization. Next, we have that the executives, the leaders inside of your organization, act like mentors and coaches, meaning that people in positions of power believe that their job and their responsibility is to help create other leaders, even if those other people become more successful than they are. So ask yourself, does your organization have a corporate culture where the leaders believe that their job and their responsibility is to help create other leaders, even if those people become more successful than they are? Lastly, we have dedicated to employee health and wellness. And this is especially becoming crucial after the impact that COVID-19 has had on organizations and on the world at large. Employees can't focus if they don't feel like their mental health, their well-being isn't being prioritized or at least considered in some way in the work environment. Forward-thinking organizations realize that mental, physical, spiritual, and emotional health is connected to performance, especially for leaders inside of organizations. So if you want to create that celebrated culture, you need to make sure that you are also thinking about employee health and well-being and wellness. By focusing on these 10 attributes of creating a celebrated culture, you will be able to create a place where you can attract and retain top talent. You will be able to create an organization that delivers killer business performance, and you will also be able to create a place where people genuinely want to show up to work each day. So after hearing these 10 attributes of a celebrated culture, ask yourself, how many of these 10 things is your organization doing, and what are the side effects of working at your company? Thanks for watching. If you want more content just like this, please remember to subscribe to the YouTube channel.